Hi guys, Brad here, and I'm currently in a hotel room in Nashville, Tennessee, because for those of you who don't know, today we sadly lost Peter Fonda, and you know, those of you who are subscribed to Thomas are more likely to know who he is. He was Grandpa Burnett Stone in Thomas and the Magic Railroad, which is what I know him most from, but I also saw him in Ghost Rider as Mephisto, which was kind of cool because, you know, I love Marvel too, so, you know, it's weird how the things work out. But I just wanted to make a thing real quick, just kind of, you know, telling you guys why this is something that really, honestly, like, sucks, not just for us Thomas fans, but just for just in general, because Peter Fonda, I don't know him personally, and you know, I never knew him personally, and you know, the cause of death was ruled as lung cancer, and the reason why that's so upsetting to me is because of the fact that I lost someone many years ago to lung cancer, someone who's in my family, and to see someone who was in a movie that ultimately shaped who I am today and my interest in film and all that sort of stuff just get taken by this awful thing, this awful disease. It really just sucks because cancer is one of those things that it's just, the worst thing about it is that, and this is a quote from Deadpool, but it's not what it does to you, it's what it does to the people around you, because because I had no idea he had lung cancer. When I read that, that's the reason he had passed. And I normally don't do videos about celebrity deaths. I don't think I ever have, honestly. But this is just something that really, really hit home for me. Just like Carrie Fisher did. And I didn't make a video on that because I feel like it was obvious that, you know, everyone was grieving at the time because everyone knows Star Wars. But I feel like a lot of people don't know about, you know, people my age that, you know, still in a way respect Thomas and the Magic Railroad as a film, because, you know, it was a flop at the box office and with critics and everything, but for a film that's about Thomas the Tank Engine, it's very, very well made. You know, it has its problems for sure, but, you know, I see a lot of people that are that did gripe about Peter's performance in that movie, and I honestly don't think that that's a necessary complaint. And I'm not just, you know, trying to blow smoke because this man passed away, but because I went through some traumatic stuff as a kid, and I won't get into it in this video because, you know, this isn't about me, this is me talking about Peter Fonda passing. But when I rewatched Magic Railroad, I sort of realized, like, honestly, and this is to sound cliche, but I realized what depression was through Peter's performance as Burnett Stone, because he played a man who had lost his wife and had sort of lost himself, and that's why, you know, he couldn't make Lady Steam again, in his own words, in the script. And it's just, it sucks. It really sucks because Thomas the Magic Railroad was honestly something that got me into filmmaking because of the behind the scenes stuff with P.T. Boomer and with just watching how the movie was made. Because honestly, I didn't know at that point that I think I was like 11 when I found out that they had used models instead of like real trains, because that kind of stuff, so that like blew my mind. I was like, oh my gosh, you can do that, like with models and whatnot. So that really blew my mind. But that, seeing that performance was something that really made me understand what depression was. But seeing that performance as well also showed me that it can be overcome. And at the end of the movie, when you finally see him smile, at the end of that big chase sequence, is so rewarding to that man. But yeah, this just really sucks, man. This really sucks. You know, I'm probably gonna just go tonight and just binge a bunch of Peter Fonda's movies. because this is a really hard hit to me, obviously, because, you know, I grew up with Thomas and Magic Railroad and all that stuff, and I, you know, watched Ghost Rider as a kid. So, yeah, that's all I have to say on the matter. Rest in peace, Peter Fonda, you magnificent man, but, you know, it's all right, because the lights are all green for you now. Green for glory.